MotoGP is the fastest vehicles of the world.
The maximum level of the sport.
The best 24 riders in the world.
Everything is so tight.
The speed is so high.
A big show, that's for sure.
Win a MotoGP title is difficult.
Everything has to be under control. The bike has to be in a perfect condition.
You need to be full focus.
Physically, we are all prepared for that. But mentally, it's very demanding.
You need the team, the people around you.
Your team is human. They can do a mistake. And you are human, and you can do a mistake.
One mistake can decide a championship.
And of course, you need to be lucky.
So there is quite a big package.
And this makes this championship super interesting, because till the end, you really don't know which rider will be the best.
We all want to win.
The main goal for every rider is to be on the number one.
If you don't have this goal, stay at home.
Always, always ready. Looking forward to start. Too long to wait, but yeah, happy. Happy to start already tomorrow. I've been doing gym, swimming pool.
Il est bien pour toi?
Ça va?
Ouais. Un peu long, début avec les médias et tout, mais après ça va.
Pas beaucoup de casino.
C'est bon. Si c'est le prix à payer, ça va.
I'm arriving super confident. I mean, I think it's important for us to arrive like that. We made a great winter. I felt great on the bike. Our pace was good.
Perfecto.
I feel at my best right now. I've never been that consistent and that good on the bike and also physically.
The goal for this 2022 is try to win the championship. For that reason, I'm training. For that reason, I get up every day for try to fight for the championship. Then we will see.
Preparado.
Sí. Estamos aquí ya. Estoy contento ya.
After two difficult years, you miss something. And it's true that step by step I'm coming back, but I understand already last year that I need to be passionate. And I believe that during the season I will be better and better. This is my main strategy. Then we will see. Of course, if I can win the first one, I will try. If I can win the second one, I will try.
The goal of this season is to be again world champion.
Vamos para allá.
This is clear. If not, I think that we stay at home. More ready than ever, I will say, because every year I feel a little bit better. I feel better prepared, also with more experience. I think that this can be a good season for us.
Siento la presión. Siento la presión.
We have a great possibility to do a good season. I think we did the best pre-season ever. The main thing will be to be more constant possible, to fight every races for the top positions. I think we are ready for this championship. It will not be easy because the level also of the other manufacturers are very high, but with our bike and we can fight for that.
Yes, you know.
Yeah,
fine.
¿Con la de este año irías bien?
Sí, ¿no?
Sí.
Es más grande, ya viste las fotos.
Sí, con la de este año
es más larga.
Bueno, muy diferente. A mí me costó, mal al principio.
Ya.
Venga, va.
Vale.
Venga, allí. Venga, Jorge.
Chao.
Izquierda, izquierda.
No.
Sí, sí, dale, vuelta.
Te he dicho, izquierda y para el puente.
¿Corto?
¿Estás ready?
Sí. Bastante bien.
¿Sí?
Sí.
¿No jolaba un poquillo, qué?
No, no, el dolor es mucho, o sea...
¿Lo hace bien el tío, qué?
Bueno, me tiene muy controlado.
Hello and a very warm welcome then to the LaSalle International Circuit in Qatar.
The beginning was difficult for me because it was a big change on the bike.
Yeah.
It was like change the brand, you know?
The 2022 FIM MotoGP World Championship looks like it's all set to be the best we've ever had in history.
Aquí se han equivocado, me parece a mí.
Último, ya está.
Wow, in top of the standings, this is difficult to say.
That's a difficult question.
First, second and third, it's very difficult. First, of course, I would say me. I believe in myself. Second, Pagnaia. And third, okay, I say Mir.
What I want is myself first. Then second and third, for me, is not a big drama.
I need to put myself first, and then I will put Mark and Bagnaia.
Me, Quartararo, Mir.
It can happen a lot of things. Someone can have a bad injury.
Some difficulties with your physical condition, some difficulties with the bike.
Problems out of the racetrack. Fighting for so ambitious goal is very difficult.
And then also, you know, one problem can create much more problem.
Fabio Quartararo lost 8th place on that last lap. A sitting duck, completely powerless, absolutely nothing he could do about this.
First part was, I would say, quite a nightmare.
A lot of talk has been that Yamaha have been in something approaching a crisis with Quartararo and the team not getting the improvement in power they necessarily wanted.
Qatar, where we expect to fight for the victory, like the previous year we finished on 9.
¿Te montó pedales en la recta o no? ¿O te pasó el zarco, no, en la última recta? Pero estaba lejos.
Bueno.
Qué impotencia.
Pero imagínate esto a final.
La impotencia, impotencia.
Aquí porque era 8 y 9. Pero sí. Imagínate, sales primero y estás así. Then Argentina, we finish 8. Cota, we finish 7th. We had quite a lot of struggle with our bike.
Here comes Rins up the inside of Quartararo.
Other bikes, other manufacturers, and also the riders make a massive improvement. and we remain a little bit the same, and it makes my life super hard. We need is more power, more acceleration.
Bagnaia has pushed Ducati to run a version of last year's engine. He just clearly wasn't comfortable throughout winter testing with the GP 2022.
Not so difficult to understand. It's not the last year engine, not this year, not completely this year engine.
Deciding in the after the last test to change everything, because the engine is the main part, was quite difficult.
I think that Ducati has to apologize in some way with Pecco, because we didn't give him the best bike in the beginning of the year.
Takes the final point, just 1 point from the first two races for Bagnaia.
I was expecting so much more for the condition of the bike and how much work we were doing. For sure, I'm the one that have to improve more, but all the team can improve on that area.
It's true that that first impression with the bike was good, because the lap time was coming, but I didn't understand nothing.
Still, I don't have that special feeling that I had in the past.
Algo está pasando, algo se nos está escapando, no solo a mí, sino a todas las ondas. Problemas inesperados.
¡Gol! ¡Caído de Marc! ¡Se ha ido al suelo Marc! Venía dándolo todo, venía aportando.
Nos cuesta demasiado. Y cuando paro al box y veo que estoy el 15, pues no me queda otra que probarlo.
The last 2 years has been a nightmare, and still I'm in this nightmare that looks like never finish.
Marc ha tenido en el warm-up una caída de alta energía que ha conllevado un traumatismo craneoencefálico. Hemos decidido el piloto y el equipo y el cuadro médico de MotoGP considerarlo anfit.
It's a mix of things. It's not only about the injury, it's not only about the diplopia, it's about a game.
Welcome back to the magnificent circuit of the Americas.
Polungo,
Madrid.
Sì, perché
diretto, no, Charlotte.
No, ho venuto di Barcellona questa volta. Barcellona. Perché ho andato dal dottore.
Ah, giusto, che era a Barcellona.
Dal dottore è andato a provare la moto.
If I'm here is because still the passion is more than the than what I suffer. So so yeah, we'll try to continue my way to improve and to fight for the title.
It's time, the moment we've all been waiting for. Round four about to get underway here in Austin, the Red Bull Grand Prix of the Americas. And away we go. Terrible start. Mar Marquez didn't get away at all. He is right at the very back of the field. Marquez has gone through by Fabio Quartararo. What a recovery. What a fight back from the back of the grid to the top six.
We are racing more on the limit than ever, so little things can make you crash.
Oh, Bagnaia's gone down. First mistake of the season then for Pecco Bagnaia. Bagnaia, incredible, crashes out of the French Grand Prix.
I'm always trying to be in the first position and push, but sometimes maybe it's better to be more smart. Understand better the situation.
Oh, Bagnaia's gone down as well. Pecco Bagnaia, who's got plenty on his plate this afternoon, he is in pain, make no mistake about it, a very sore right shoulder.
È la prossima Arezzo. No. Sembra di no. Dobbiamo vedere martedì il legamento perché secondo me c'è qualcosa di strano.
Was quite painful. I was close to broke everything in my shoulder, so wasn't easy.
Puoi provare a guidare?
Maybe I have to be more mature, understand what to do differently and start doing, because we are always one of the fastest, but not the strongest.
The bombshell started to drop on the Monday following the Spanish Grand Prix, the Jerez test, where news began to emerge that Suzuki were considering leaving MotoGP at the end of 2022.
Sí, primero nos lo comunicaron a nosotros y luego se hizo como una reunión y se contó esto. Y eso es una...
Un batacazo, perdona.
Un batacazo. No, no, porque no, es esta cosa que no sospechaba, o sea, para nada.
Tú corres, eres campeón del mundo con Suzuki y a los dos años se retira tu madre.
Yo creo que ellos cuando me ficharon tampoco lo pensaban, creo, ¿eh?
No, ¿que no iban a ser campeones o que
no,
se iban a retirar?
Que se iban a retirar.
No, claro,
y que
claro,
los campeones pero, tampoco.
Es un poco heavy todo, ¿no? O sea,
sí, es muy heavy.
No lo entiendes.
No, yo no lo entiendo.
Qué marrones, tío.
A mí me dieron unos marrones.
Entonces, el plan que tiene era devolverlo.
Sí, tela.
With the level that are in the sport, you have to have everything under control to perform at 100%.
Oh, man's gone down. What a turbulent 2 weeks it's been for the factory Suzuki team.
It has been probably the hardest first part of the season on my career.
His third DNF in the last four races. The world title hopes of Mir in 2022 are already starting to slip away.
Mentally, the situation is not easy. If we can solve this problem and I'm able to be strong, I know that I'm able to win. It is a matter of time that we will be back where we want and where we deserve.
Of course, I'm not satisfied because at the end, don't win a championship making P8. You win a championship fighting for podiums and top five. And actually, right now, we are not ready for that. And this is really frustrating.
I cannot be back.
Fabio Quartararo, he can do no more. You can only fight with the weapons you're given, and he fought tooth and nail to the checkered flag. You can see the problems he's having so far this year.
It is what it is.
I realized this season that I'm not enjoying. I'm just suffering a lot of pain. I don't have power. I cannot ride like I want. I had a phone call yesterday at 12 between one practice to the other one. I will have a surgery next week. My riding style is not the same one, not because the bike, it's because me. True that my goal is the same one, and it's come back. If you want something, you need to push, you need to believe on it, and you need to keep pushing. Looks like a nightmare, but I believe that soon I will come back. And yeah, I don't know the time.
Avevi detto, eh? Tre mesi! Marco, siamo grandi! E noi ti aspettiamo con
voi! Devi dimostrare più niente!
No, 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 però la notizia è su, molto buona questa che ti hanno detto. Es buon fecho, che tal? Saps? No, no. Que tingui les ganes de seguir aquí. Tot lo que tens i tot lo que has guanyat, pues, jo crec que... Has participat en el
mòbil a missatge
de la Marc? No pensis, no sé. Bueno, ahora miraré. Tinc modo avión de moment.
Se agradece. No, hombre.
No. No está para ganar el Mundial, tampoco. Así no se puede ganar el Mundial.
¿Quién es el favorito ahora que
no lo fuera? No sé qué decirte. ¿Llevo a Aleix Espargaró o qué?